So the bike doesn't charge. Battery goes dead while I'm riding. I got a pigtail hooked up. I'm just gonna run it and connect my voltmeter so you can see. It should be running at about 14 and a half at 3000 RPM, according to the manual. Let's get this all gooded to go. Good. Okay, so your charging system is made up of two components. Your stator, which is in here, which means I have to take this whole thing apart to get at it, and your rectifier, which is behind your passenger peg. The clutch side? Left side of the bike. So behind here, and the reason that it's behind here is that it gets hot because it's essentially just a series of resistors and diodes. They are connected, not that one, this one and this one. So you find the three white wires connected to three white on the other end, and this goes to your battery from your rectifier. So stator is the braided cable. It's got three white wires in it. It comes in, plugs into your rectifier, and it has power coming out with this one. The rectifier is grounded to the frame. Okay, so this is what your rectifier looks like. It's probably dirtier. This is my replacement, some cheap Chinese knockoff. The best eBay can provide that isn't like $100. Way to test it. This is your voltmeter. Go to continuity setting, it'll beep if you've got perfect continuity, meaning you can get a circuit through. If it doesn't have perfect continuity, like if it goes through some sort of resistance, this is a load resistor. You use it to simulate the resistance of incandescent bulbs, so you can switch over to LED, and it should be able to go through but not get the beep. It got the beep. But it is rated for 6 ohms, so ta-da. This one is going to be rated much higher, a lot more resistance because it's dealing with much higher voltages, alternating current voltages, coming off of your stator. And the way you test it is you go backwards. You don't connect red to red, you connect black to red, and then you connect, and then you touch each wire. And you should be able to get continuity on each wire. So that's 370, 376, 377. So that works. And then the other way is you hook up power to the ground, which is just the casing, and then you touch each of the wires. 351, 375, 356. So this one looks a little bit off. They should be within 10 of each other, but again, the cheapest eBay can provide. Testing on the bike is a little bit more difficult. You can't test the rectifier while it's connected to the bike because the battery is connected. If you disconnect the battery, you're okay, but I've already taken out the battery and put a new battery in thinking that was the problem. So this being the stator, you unplug here, and what you're doing, again, get your voltmeter out, testing continuity to ground. If you can touch ground, which is the frame, and one of the wires, and you hear the beep, your stator is shorted. So all three of the wires on my stator are shorted. Quickest thing to check, is there a short in the wire? There isn't, which means I need a new stator. There's also this little pigtail thing. I have no idea. But it looks like it's important. I don't know what this is for, but maybe an extra ground wire or something, I don't know. You're gonna have a lovely time now, because you're gonna have to drop the oil, take the clutch cable out, disconnect the starter, solenoid, something. This thing, your shifter, you have to take this out, your guards, engine guards, and your highway bars if you've got them. You have to take half the bike apart to get at the stator. In here, there's one of those Torx bits, the T30 is what you're going to need to take it apart. It's not included in your standard, non-standard bike kit. But yeah, I've got the engine warmed up. I'm gonna drop the oil now, and we'll continue. All right, I got the oil dropped. No little metal shavings on the magnet on the end of that thing. If you do need to see how to do an oil change on this bike, I got another video. A little trick I've learned: make a super detailed drawing of what you're taking apart, and then just punch the screws through the cardboard so they stay put. Now for the clutch. We actually have to take it out to be able to get the thing off. So I'm going to be removing this. I'm not going to be worrying about just bending this tab around or anything like that. If you need to see how the clutch comes out and gets replaced, I've got another video. I got this part off. I can disconnect it from there, but it looks like I can get at everything. I think I can do the rest without taking any more of the bike apart, so I'm going to try. If I can't, you'll get an update. Okay, I've gotten about this far. I got the clutch off, and I got the cover for my starter off. There are two Phillips Phillips heads that are facing this way. One right here, and one right here. This one feels like it is almost entirely stripped, so I got to be very careful. But getting in there is tight. So what I'm going to try and do is get my extender out. The Phillips on the other end. In case you don't have a Phillips attachment thing, you get a 1/4 bit, and that'll fit your different screwdriver heads. Using the 6-inch extender worked, but I ended up having to use a 6 and 4-inch together to get at that one from the complete other side, because the angle wouldn't work otherwise with the screw that stripped. Okay, this is a bit tricky. There's that Torx bolt, which is now on my lovely diagram, with one of these holding it in place. What that's doing is that's engaging and disengaging your starter. So if you pull this whole thing off with that still connected, it's going to pull out the clutch system and your starter. So be sure to do that one first. Don't forget to take that one off. This pivots. There's a little Allen bolt right under here that I didn't notice at first. There's a gasket here, a couple of nuts, just to pull the starter off. But I'm going to have to take this off before I can get the starter out. It looks like it's just hooked on there. But yeah, just be careful with this whole section. Okay, so I got it off. But the piece that came out with it was the part I was supposed to make sure, absolute sure, stayed there, because putting it back is a huge pain. And this is your starter clutch assembly or something. And it is a bunch of gears that are very well lubed and very precision made. And they connect to everything in the bit. An engine, god damn it. It turns out my gasket has cracked. That's not good because I don't have a replacement. And my stator is held in place by 3 Allen bolts. That's what it looks like. That's the piece that's got to come out. And this is what it's supposed to look like when it's brand new. It looks fried. It looks very old. So I'm going to put a new one in. We'll see if that fixes the problem. If it doesn't, I'm going to swear a bit and have a beer. Oh, I also discovered that the bike is bleeding and I got some on my hand. Okay, I got my assembly back in. It was a little bit of a push. You just got to make sure that there's a washer behind this one. What happens is this is getting spun by your starter motor. At the same time, your activator pulls out on this one, which slides this gear in with, I guess this is your main gear or something to do with spinning the thingamajigger. The spinamathingin. And that's how it works. But you gotta make sure to put it back together properly if you do something stupid like I did. I think if you keep pressure on this pin
which is what's behind this one. If you keep pressure on this pin, you should be all right. But I didn't do that. It just sort of came out with it, and then it was too late. Okay, so I thought this would be fairly straightforward. Just these three Allens keeping it down. But this little Phillips head is keeping the wiring together. And I'm getting close to stripping that. There's a lot of oil in here, and I'm slipping. It's lubricating a bit, so I'm going to try and figure something out here. So, more grip, more better. Remember I said I didn't know where that blue wire went? Well, it comes out of the wiring harness, and then goes off and is attached to the bike somewhere under here. So I got to disconnect that somehow, and then the stator's out. This was just done with a number 2 Phillips screwdriver. I just had to loosen it to take it off, but it's got a little nice rubber gasket thing. I don't know if my new one has that, so I'm going to keep that if I can. This just looks like it's there to create a good seal between the engine casing right here and the outside world, which is dirty as hell. Couple of notes. Getting this one off, that's a number 3 screw, not a number 2. That's probably why I was starting to strip it. It occurred to me that these ones on the starter motor or starter solenoid plunger kajigger, it was also 2 number 3s, which I'm going to end up replacing with Allens if I've got them. So my suspicion is that this crud that's built up over 10 years has been 20 years, I'm old, has baked off some of the insulation that's on the wire here. I'm gonna put it on my super awesome GoPro stand. There we go. Now, if I test continuity, ground between any of these wires, I mean, probably touching here. Yeah, that's ground. But touching any of these wires? Shouldn't. But if I get in here, yep, there's my short. Is that the wires are dead right in this little pocket where stuff has begun to crud up. So that's where my short is occurring. And there it is. Short between the wire and ground. Not good. So this is the faulty component, and I've already got a replacement put in. However, taking out of my super awesome GoPro stand. One thing I did not buy in anticipation of this job is this gasket, which I have ripped to shreds putting the new stator in. So I am going to post this video as a part 1, and part 2 will be me putting the gasket on and putting the bike back together and getting her on the road. Bloody hell. Video pro tip when you're working on this stuff: old computer fans hook up to an old 12-volt power supply makes working in a garage without air conditioning a lot easier.